This is Oreo. Oreo's been at the restaurant 10 years since we opened. We got her fixed 10 years ago. She gets an organic raw food diet. And she lives out here in the garden. The restaurant. So I'm back at one of my favorite areas here in Ulster County. Up on Geiger Road. Out riding my bike today. I was up on the bridge there. Some guys fishing. I said hi to them. Nobody responded to me. I don't know if they're cranky or constipated. But they weren't friendly. Let's put it that way. I don't know if they thought I was going to scare the fish or what. Although there's some construction going on down the street there. And a huge bulldozer just went over the bridge. So my hello probably wasn't nothing compared to what the what the bulldozer did to the fish. So I don't know. Maybe they're just constipated. So I want to talk about today about not getting burnt out as a restaurant owner. So go check out my my website, 50mistakes.com. There comes a car on the road. 50mistakes.com. It's a cyber coaching website for restaurateurs and really any business owner can go on there and get some useful, very useful information. I got a lot of fans on there. I get emails from all over the world. And one of my things on there is, you know, don't get burnt out as a restaurant owner, as a business owner. And have fun doing what you're doing. So I had a nice run this weekend, met some new people, had some great conversations out on the trail. I like to talk when I run. When I'm with people, I like to be, I think running's a social thing, so I like to go out with people no matter how slow they are. It's never about the time, right? It's never about, well, I got to beat my time and I can't run with you. It's always about whose company can I enjoy and what can we talk about. And, you know, that's what running's for me. It's a social sport. So, you know, of course, people start asking, oh, you own a restaurant and how don't you get, do you ever take days off? Do you ever go on vacations? Do you get burnt out? And, you know, in the first, I've been open 10 years, in the first 3 years of my restaurant, we never took days off. We, if we wanted to go away, we'd actually close the restaurant, and it was a real bummer to close the restaurant, to go away, because we couldn't make money while we were away, right? Now when we go away, my wife and I go away every other month we're traveling, and other restaurant owners are like, how do you do that? How do you do that? Like, because I trust my staff, I empower my staff, I train my staff. That's so key. A lot of people don't understand. You have to trust your staff. If you're going to hire people, you've got to trust them. You've got to train them. You've got to give them the proper tools. You've got to keep training them. You've got to role play, and all that's on my 50mistakes.com website, 50mistakes.com. And of course, as a restaurant owner, you have to have a passion of your own. You know, I love the restaurant. It doesn't feel like work for me, so that's my passion. But besides that, I love running. I love cycling. I love the outdoors. I have a family. I spend a lot of time with them. I try not to miss games. I try not to miss horse shows, even though I still do, because I have the restaurant. I do have to work sometimes. There are crunch times. And typically, people ask me, what do you do at the restaurant? I'm like, I do as little as possible. That's why I hire a staff. And I kind of make a joke about that. But in reality, you know, I do some work. But in reality, you know, all the menial things, all the day-to-day operations, all that stuff is performed by people who I hire. I do the analytics. I do the marketing. I do the promotions. I do things like that. So that's why I sit at the desk and get creative. And I also help out in the kitchen, you know, with coming up with new specials and things like that. Because, of course, food is my passion. And but it's so easy as a restaurant owner just to get, you know, to bust your butt all day long. And 365 days a year, just bust your butt. And it's easy to go to work and start drinking and, you know, and get drunk and just go through your whole workday buzzed or just enthralled in a bunch of work as a restaurant owner. I see a lot of restaurant owners that do that. They just don't know how to break away. What taught me to break away was joining a mastermind group. So I joined a mastermind group with other successful restaurateurs, and we meet four times a year across the country, and we lock ourselves in a conference room, and we share our marketing and operational ideas, everything. But it forced me to get away. So the way a mastermind group is effective is when you have to pay for it. Don't you know, forming your own mastermind group and not having a fee for a membership is kind of useless because nobody really values it. When I started my mastermind, we were paying almost $1,000 a month. So I said, okay, I'm going to spend 12 grand a year on this mastermind group. I might as well get the most out of it, right? I need to figure out a way to make my restaurant run while I'm not there. So that was a really, really key part of doing that was, you know, I've spent this money. Now it's all of a sudden time to figure out what's going on and how to get to these meetings. And I haven't missed a meeting in 7 years probably haven't missed a meeting. So it's been a really powerful tool in my, when you trust your staff and empower your staff, they want to do good for you. They want to do better. They feel proud that you've entrusted them and you've given them titles and you've given them the tools and the training to succeed. So get onto my website, 50mistakes.com. Check it out. There's a lot of cool things on there. It's all free. All free cyber coaching. There's tons and tons of videos there. So back on my bike to my other passion, outdoors.